chronic inflammation and mucus hypersecretion, the factors responsible for various respiratory diseases, including throat and lung cancers. Prevention and Management Through Exercise Interventions by Manikonda Prakash Rao, Hyderabad. Excellent Healthcare awarded at Indo-Global Healthcare Summit and Expo 2014. Introduction. The objective of the paper is to create awareness among people about alternative and complementary methods to protect themselves from respiratory diseases like asthma, bronchitis, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, throat and lung cancers, etc. The diseases cause the following changes in airways. Inflammation is a physiological process and plays the role of immunological defense against infection, injury, or allergy. Acute inflammation is a defense process, whereas chronic inflammation is a disease process. As a result of the above factors, inflammatory cell recruitment commences. Hypersecretion of mucus is the result of goblet cell hyperplasia in respiratory mucosa and is a prominent feature of inflammation and is a major pathological feature of airway diseases. They are interrelated. Chronic mucus hypersecretion is a potential risk factor for an accelerated loss of lung function. The thick viscous mucus in the lungs will be conducive to pathogens. Chronic inflammation and mucus hypersecretion may significantly contribute to transformation of normal cells into cancer cells. That is, the scope for series of mutations on genes may get increased. Bronchospasm is an additional factor in asthma patients. Insights. According to Dr. Sarah Herrick, a research fellow, Dr. Robin Gore, a consultant in respiratory medicine, a research fellow, and Dr. David Thornton, a senior lecturer in the Faculty of Life Sciences at Manchester University, who were conducting research 2008 and 11 as a team into the factor of hypersecretion of mucus. An abnormal production of mucus in the airways is a major contributor to the pathology of asthma as well as other debilitating respiratory conditions such as cystic fibrosis and chronic pulmonary obstructive disease. Insights continued. They opined that no mucus-directed therapies are available for asthmatics, and the factors that lead to excessive mucus secretion during breath, chronic and severe asthma are not understood. Further, presently available drugs like mucolytics, mucokinetics, mucoregulator steroids, expectorants, etc. are not able to meet the needs of the sufferers. Sometimes in serious cases like chronic bronchitis and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, patients are referred to physiotherapists for the removal of excess and sticky mucus from the throat and lungs through a percussion methodology which is currently in use but without any success. Further, chronic inflammation and its prominent feature, hypersecretion mucus or feces that ignite many airway diseases, including throat and lung cancers. Without these two factors, there cannot be inflammatory cell recruitment to the site of infection, injury, or allergy. Continued presence of inflammatory cells or carcinogens may lead to cycles of tissue injury and repair, resulting in carcinogenesis of the airways. That is, the gene damaging effect gets increased. Therefore, treating these two factors is very important for airway integrity and to protect from airway diseases, including throat and lung cancers. For resolution of the said factors, a rapid programmed clearance of excess mucus is necessary. As a result, the origin of it, inflammation, gets resolved. Depending upon the stage of the disease, medicinal assistance becomes necessary. Since the upper airway passages and bronchial airways constitute only one pathway, the exercises explained should be practiced from upper airway passages. Methods. Exercises evolved or a potent medication in history. They are mucokinases. They help in cleansing the adhesive mucus from mouth, nose, pharynx, the primary sites of colonization of pathogens, sinuses, the waste stations to the brain and the bronchial airways. They reduce C-reactive protein, resulting in reduced inflammation. Exercises strengthen the remodeled airways and reset the biological aging process. There is no substitute for exercise. Methods. upper airway passages and lung cleaning exercises. The exercises are based on the following concept. Living cells are osmotic system. They shrink in hypertonic solution and swell in hypotonic solution. Take a glass of hypertonic solution. Keep it at the entrance of the nasal passages. Bend the body forward to about 70 to 80 degrees. Slowly snort in the solvent. It goes in through the nostrils, up through the nasal passages, down in throat pharynx, from where it takes a U-turn, enter the oral cavity and collects in the mouth. Spit it out. Blow out the nose forcefully. The excess mucus collected in upper airway passages gets drained out through mouth. Defunct cilia become active and ciliate mucus from lungs towards upper airway passages mouth. It can be pushed out easily. And any mucus left over can be cleaned through bronchial airways cleaning exercises. Physical, aerobic and yogic exercises. Upper airway passages cleaning exercises. These exercises should be practiced with hypertonic solution. That is a solution having greater osmotic pressure than that of cells or body fluids and draws water out of cells, thus inducing plasmolysis. The solution should be warmer than that of body temperature, that is more than 37 degrees Celsius. Better results can be achieved with 40 to 41 degrees Celsius. Bronchial airways cleaning exercises. They are based on inspiratory and expiratory reserve volumes of the patients and forced expiratory techniques. They help in draining out any mucus left over from lower airways. Physical, aerobic and yogic exercises strengthens the inspiratory and expiratory muscles and make the airways flexible. Fact: any mucus related respiratory health problem commences from upper airway passages and spread to tracheobronchial tree, as they constitute only one pathway. The mucociliary clearance mechanism becomes defunct when excess and sticky mucus forms. Once they are cleaned, the defunct cilia become active and ciliate mucus towards mouth, and it can be pushed out easily. The whole of the lungs get cleaned. Result of the exercises, respiratory and other diseases originating from its pathway come under control. Conclusion: the exercises are based on the concept. Once the offending factor, excess mucus, is removed, the origin of its inflammation gets resolved. As a result of management of the above factors, the gene damaging effect gets reduced. That is, the scope for repeated pressures of mutations on genes get reduced. Thank you for your time.